Dear all, this is a video about the check on the score sheet received from the TCS. Once the exams are over, you will be receiving the these two folders. That is, you will be receiving the online and offline folders. That is, one will be containing configured report subject wise and the NPTEL subject wise score. These two folders contains the score sheets. The rest of the now I am going to explain you the checks to be done on this sheets. In the NPTEL configured report subject wise sheet, what we need to do is, we need to do a check on this. Once you receive the score sheet, kindly check the name, email ID, date of birth and the application number are there in this configured data sheet. If it's missing, kindly send it back to the TCS. Concerned respective people, you'll be given an email ID. Using that email ID, send an email to that person, TCS contact person, and get those details in the configured Excel sheet. Once, before sharing these sheets, we'll be checking it once, and after that only we'll be sending. If it's missing in that sheet, kindly ask those details from the TCS and get the appropriate response sheet from the TCS. This is actually the response of the candidate, whatever the answers they have selected in the online paper. So this is the online paper response sheet for each and every candidate. Whatever answers they have selected, you could able to see it in this sheet. So for each and every section, for each and every question, you will be given a question ID. So you won't be having the question number in this sheet. So question number is, question ID will be the reference for us, and option ID will be given here. Option name also won't be displayed here. So once you receive this sheet, you know the total number of candidates who are present on the first exam. So for basic campus, say like 15 candidates are present or 30 candidates are present. Let me see how many candidates are present in this examination. Since 55 candidates are present for this examination, each should have 4 rows commonly. That is, not 4 rows, actually it's 5 rows, I think. Actually it's question ID, question value, option ID, score and correct option. These are the 6 columns that will be static for all the candidates. These may not be changed. So question ID will be given for each and every questions for all the sections, and the question type, whatever it is, MCQ, MSQ or short answer type questions will be displayed here. Option ID and sequence, which is not necessary, that is just for reference, and the score we need to get for all the candidates. And the correct option ID or value is the one which we need to compare it with the candidate selector option ID or value. So these 6 columns will be static for 6 rows will be static for all the response sheet. So now what we need to do is, this is a candidate response over here. This is a candidate response for this candidate, that is Shankaran. He has given the result, score and question status, selected option ID or value. So for question number, question ID 1611, his answer is correct. What he has selected, we can see it over here. Selected option ID or value here is 41186. And the correct option ID, what we have setted in the back end, is 41186. Since both matches, he has been given a score 2 and has marked been correct. And the question status, he has been marked for review, or he would have answered whatever, maybe this we can take it as a reference only, this is not much needed. So for us, let me see for the answers which is wrong. So here what the answer is, the correct app option ID or value should be 1141191, but he has selected 41190, so it is wrong and he has awarded 0 marks. Similarly, we can check the scores for MCQ. Once you receive this, kindly check this criteria, that is compare the selected option ID or value and correct option ID or value for 2 or 3 candidates and confirm whether this auto graded value is okay, that is it's fine, the scores are awarded fine. Once you are okay with this, then we need to share it to the professor. So this is for MCQ type. For short answer type, what you will be given is the question number is short answer. So here no option ID or value won't be there, since for short answer type of questions, the candidate needs to type his response in the online software. So in that, the correct option ID or value should be -2. But what he has entered is, that is in the selected option ID or value, what he has given is 0. So he is awarded 0 marks for that, since the answer is wrong. So the candidate may give -1 also here. So some of the candidates have given, you can check it over here. If the candidate has given -1, -1.25, he may awarded some marks. But what the software will do is, it will search for the exact answer. If it is -2, then only it will award mark. If it is -1.9 also, it won't award marks. So what we need to do is, we need to check it out here. Since if the candidate has given -1.9 here, then we can ask the professor whether he can provide any marks to the candidate. If he says okay, you can change the score here and you can highlight it with the color. And for -2, if the candidate has given -2, if a space was there, then the candidate will be awarded 0 only. So what we need to check is, we need to check whether the answer is -2 matches here -2, and if he has given a wrong answer, we need to provide him the correct marks for the question. So if there may be a minus value or space value also, if a space is detected over there, then he will be awarded 0. So whatever is given in the selector correct option ID or value in the back end, it should be exactly match with that, and the space or any other 2 more spaces if he has added, that will also be considered as a wrong answer only. And then what we need to do is, for MCQ similarly, we need to check the options. For MSQ type of questions, it is similar to that of the MCQ, and the 2 option IDs which have been set in the back end should match with the selected option ID or value for the candidate's response. If he has given one answer as correct, it will be marked as PC here, that is partial correct. You can ask the professor whether he can give marks or not. If he accepts to give the marks, kindly provide the score here, and finally you need to do the sum of all the scores. So if these type of questions are given, if these types of questions are given here, we need to send a draft mail to the professor once we receive these type of response sheet from the professor. Once you receive the response sheet, what we need to do is, we need to share the So these are the checks to be done here. So once you receive this response sheet from the TCS, what we need to do is, we can check randomly the MCQ type of question and the essay type of question, whether the marks are awarded appropriately. Then if not, we need to report it to the TCS that the online evaluation has been done wrong. What we need to do is, we need to check the MCQ type of questions. If the answers are correct option ID and selected option ID matches with the same and the scores are awarded correctly, then we can leave it. So if any criteria, if it has been mentioned as wrong, if both are matches, and then also if they have given wrong answer and they have not given the score, we need to report it to the TCS. These are the checks to be done at first. So once these checks are done, what we need to do is, we need to send these sheets to the professor. That is, consolidated score sheet and response sheet. Response sheet for the course name, you need to mention it here. That is, this is for 8th November, and for 1st November also you need to give it to the professor. So you need to mention him in the mail that the short answer type of questions has to be evaluated by him or by the TAs by cross-checking it with the correct option ID and the selected option ID. And these sections need to be highlighted with some other color. And this should be mentioned in the email so that the professor or the TA will look into this and they will provide marks for this. And at last, what we need to do is, we need to do a sum of this. Some of these scores for all the candidates. So this is the thing we need to do in this file. Similarly, the response sheet for the 1st November has also to be checked, and that response sheet has to be given to the professor along with this. So these are the sheets to be shared to the professor: response sheet for the first exam and the second exam, and this consolidated score sheet should be provided by us. Now this sheet, how I will explain you how to prepare this consolidated score sheet. This consolidated score sheet will be given to you. This NPTEL subject wise score, this sheet will be provided to all the IITs from the TCS. So on seeing this sheet, once we open this sheet, this response sheet will be given to you based on the date wise, 1st and 8th. And the subject wise scores also will be given to you based on the dates, 1st and 8th. This is a subject wise score sheet which will be given to you for the final candidates who appeared for the exam. This is only for 1st November. So for 8th November also you will be given a sheet like this. So you need to prepare the consolidated score sheet. Which should be in this format. So the first format should be course ID. Template should be in this format: course ID, roll number, first name, email, and then we need to map the assignment scores to the professor. And these logics will be given to you once the course ends. The professor will be posting the exam score calculation logic in the announcement and the forum. Based on this, we need to put these columns over here. And the scores also we need to mention here: exam score, exam score from TCS out of 100. This column has to be filled once the professor says confirmation, sends the confirmation mail to you. Once this essay type questions and MCQ questions are evaluated by the professor, calculate those scores from the response sheet. This response sheet, you need to calculate this overall score for each and every candidate. If there is any changes, you can calculate this score and you need to mention here. You need to update the score. At first, what you need to have is final exam score from TCS out of 100, and faculty updated score should be given here. And one more column: final updated score from faculty out of 100. So we will share you this template for you. In this template, you need to fill all the details. First, it should contain course ID, roll number, applicant first name, email ID, the assignment map, and the details of this, that is a calculation logic, should be given a column over here. The final exam score from TCS out of 100, which should be updated here from this sheet, out of 100. This sheet contains the score from TCS out of 100. So this is a total score over here. Do a VLOOKUP based on this email ID, and have a, you will be given a final registered data, is it? What we need to do is, we need to prepare another sheet. That is, the sheet to be sent to the professor should contain present details here, absent details in the second sheet, and the third sheet should contain the consolidated score. In the consolidated score, the template should be in this format as follows. So as for this, what we need to do is we need to get the course ID, roll number, name, email ID from the final candidate data template. That is, we have obtained the attendance details here in the sheet, right? From this sheet, you need to take the first name, email ID and all these details, and you need to copy these in this Excel sheet, and you need to map the assignment details also here. And then you need to update the final score from TCS out of 100 from the sheet they have given to you. Subject wise score sheet they would have been shared with you. From this sheet we need to get the total score out of 100, or it may be out of 70, the exam may be out of 70 also. So you need to calculate the total score, get this total score in the sheet that we are going to send to the professor. Do a VLOOKUP and get the scores from TCS. And then what is this column? Final updated score from faculty out of 100. This should be that whatever the professor has evaluated, no, in this file the professor may have given some marks or slight changes will be there. So if he has given some marks, calculate this in this column and then do a VLOOKUP based on the email ID and get the scores here from the faculty out of 100. So that's it. If there is no change, then copy the final score from the TCS out of 100 and paste it here as the same, since we have received the confirmation from the professor that there is no change. If there is no change, you can copy this column out of 100 and paste it here. Else you need to copy the updated score from there to here. Now we are going to map the assignment details here, assignment scores here. So before mapping this assignments course here, we need to take a dump from the online courses portal. This assignment dump has to be taken from the online courses portal once all the deadlines gets over from the course. So what we need to do is, before taking the dump, you need to log in to the course using the reviewer email ID, not using the course email ID, that is the admin email ID. Before taking the dump, we need to log in to the online courses portal using the reviewer login ID. Each and every course will be having a reviewer ID which will be shared to you. You will be given a reviewer email ID, reviewer1@npetel.itm.ac.in, and the password will be given to you. So for each and every course, before taking the dump, you need to log into the reviewer ID, not using the admin ID. Just log into this, click on each and every assignments. And check whether the due date has been ended or not. Since the due date has been over, I have taken the assignment dump on 12/11. For all the assignments, the assignment due date has been over, so I have taken the assignment dump. And what you need to do is, you need to get the assignment score for this. So you need to, the assignment name, the in the dump you may get the assignments which have been created for reference in the admin ID, but they may have deleted further. So what we need to do is, we need to check it first. We need to check whether those assignments which are in live, that is the candidates have submitted, that only we need to add in the dump. So first log into this course, check whether these assignments, whatever assignments are visible in the reviewer login, that assignments course only should be in this profile dump. So this assignment one score has not been here, since they have created this assignment and they have used Google Forms, this course has to be given from the professor. So once you receive that score from the professor, you can get it. So mention this column as A1 and leave it as blank. If it has course here, kindly check the dump. If the dump has assignments course, you can get the assignment score for those candidates alone. And check assignment 2. Assignment 2, the assignment number is 78. So it may have duplicate also. Assignment 2 may be repeated here anymore again. So what you need to do is the assignment number, what it has is 78, and assignment 2 is viewable in the public, so in the reviewer login. So you can take this code. For assignment 3 also it's viewable. Assignment 4, 5. So you need to check all these columns. New assessment is created only for reference, and this is not available in this online courses portal. So you can delete these columns 5, 6, 7, and 8. These are the assignment scores which are to be taken. So to take this assignment score, what we need to do is from the consolidated sheet do a VLOOKUP and get these assignment scores alone, these 8 assignment scores alone, and get the average assignment score. Since the professor has given the formulas average assignment score out of 100, you need to fill this column. The formula is that we need to sum up all the A1 to A8 assignments, and average assignment score out of 100, you need to calculate it. So average of it divided by 8 is, you will be getting the average assignment score out of 100, and then 40% of assignment score. The professor has given 40% of average of all assignments. So I am doing it step by step. So we need to mention all the steps in separate columns. So 40% assignment score, final score from TCS out of 100, and final updated score from faculty out of 100 after his re-evaluation from the response sheet. Then 60% of exam score over here. I have calculated it. Since this is out of 100, I have calculated it for 60 into 60 by 100 and rounded off that value. So final certificate score will be a combination of 40% assignment score plus 60% examination score. So once you create this template, you need to fill all these columns. It might be lack over here for few professor which who may not be giving us a logic for that. You need leave those columns, consolidated assignment score and the exam score column, as blank, and send this to the professor and get the logic from him, and then get the do the calculation. If he has given the calculation already, do this calculation and keep this final certificate score as ready. So if he has provided some marks, then he will be filling it here and he may be giving you. Else you need to fill this column if the professor has given the score separately. If not, you just take this as an exam score and convert it over for 60% and then do the final calculation. This needs to be given to the NPTEL for uploading the scores in the portal. For uploading the scores in the NOC website, you need to give the scores in the following format. So that template, I will be sharing it to you. That is 2DB. So assignment score template will be there and update exam score template will be there. What you need to fill is, roll number should be added here. That is from the consolidated score sheet. What you are giving it to the professor, you need to copy the roll number from this and the assignment scores which are to be given, A1 to A14, or 8 assignments are there for elements of visual representation. So fill 8 assignment scores over here and delete this rest of these columns and give the score, assignment score template. And the second one is, you need to fill the update exam score template. In this NOC course ID, which should be in the format of NOC15-, this is HS16. Since they have 8 candidates, marking it here, and the roll number has to be given here. Score from assignment, whatever we are publishing in the website, it should be out of 100. So what you need to do is, we are calculating it here for 100. Average assignment score out of 100. So this assignment scores has to be displayed in the NOC website. So out of 100 assignment score should be displayed here. Exam score out of 100. If the exam is for 80%, what you need to do is, you need to convert it to 100% and then copy that cells here and paste it. And again, what you need to do is final score. Final score, it should be out of 100. That is the 60% exam score plus 40%, this is a final certificate score. This should be copied and given to the NPTEL. That's it. And one more detail, what we need is, before we need to upload it in the NOC portal, we need the assignment mapping details, which needs to be in the following format. This assignment map, A map, should be given to the NPTEL for uploading it in the website. So what you need to do is, you need to mention the course ID here. This template will also be given to you. You need to give the course ID here. Total assignments has to be given here. So since it has 8 assignments, you are giving 8. And go and check in the online courses portal and provide the details here. Since it has 8 weeks in this, they have given 8 weeks. So I have mentioned 8 weeks here. An assignment map, the first week they have given A1. Weeks you need to mention here is 1. So since it has 8 weeks, you need to mention it here. Each week has 1 assignment, so I have given in this format. Some may be like this, A1, A2, A3 may belong to first week. So whatever is given in this portal, check with the week wise details and give the assignment map detail for each and every course. Using this only, we will be updating it in the NOC portal. So these are the sheets that has to be shared to NPTEL and the professor. So you will be given a format that whatever needs to be shared with the professor has to be like this. To professor, what we need to share is, we need to share the response sheet and the consolidated score sheet. This sheet will be taken from the final candidate registered data. The present candidate details alone we need to take. No need of taking the absent candidate details. We need to take the assignment scores for them, do the calculation and keep it ready. Present and absent candidate details also should be given over here. And the response sheet for both the exams has to be kept ready. These sheets has to be shared to the professor. Once you receive this, you need to proceed this consolidated score sheet and update in the format that I will be giving to you, 2DB. These sheets are to be given in this assignment score template and update score template, and this sheets to be shared to the NPTEL for uploading in the NOC portal. Thank you.